So let's do the first stage. We're going to select. Well, how do we do selection in an MDP? Well, we follow a policy, right? So there's going to be some policy that we have. Let's not worry about where it comes from right now, but some policy based on experience that tells us what we ought to be doing in some state. So let's say, for the sake of argument, I'm in this particular state, and my policy tells me that I should take a particular action, and I take that action, let's say it's this one, and it ends me up in this state. Well, once we end up in this particular state, let's say the policy still tells us what to do, and it says, oh, take an action, and when I take that action, I end up in yet another state, and the policy says, well, from here, you should take a particular action, so I take that action, and then I end up in this state, okay? So I have a policy. The policy tells me how to select what to do, what actions I should take, and it gets me through the tree until I get to a place where I don't know what to do. So at this point in the tree, and in fact, just so you know, the way I've drawn this tree, all the leaves of the tree are places where I don't know where to go next. I don't have a policy for it. I've got to figure out what to do. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm at this state. I don't know what to do next. I have to do something. So I'm going to do expansion, and then I'm going to do simulation. So here's how the expansion state, the expansion step works. From this state, I can take a bunch of actions, right? And from those actions, I can get to a bunch of states. In fact, I can just look at my transition model and I can see all the possible next states I might end up at based upon the actions that I take. And often that's what you would do. That's what you would do in a normal kind of game AI classical tree search. The problem here, of course, is that we might have many, 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 many states. And so we don't want to expand out the tree that much. So instead of what we're going to do is we're going to kind of do a sort of sampling step. We're going to say, well, for each of the actions that I might take, why don't I take that action and then simulate for one step what state I might end up in? And then do that for another action, and then do that for another action, and so on and so forth until I have a few possible next state action pairs that I might see. And maybe that number is really small. Maybe it's 6. Maybe it's 100. It sort of depends upon your state space. So I've done the expansion step. I've figured out where I might end up next, given all the actions that I might take. So I'm not drawing this because there's not a lot of room, but each one of these edges represents some particular action I could have taken, or I did take in my imagination, and the state that I ended up in, or what the nodes represent. And so each one of these edges has some action that's associated with it. I'm just not writing it down because of space. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So now I've got this. So I've now expanded sort of the fringe. Here's all the things that I might do and where I might end up next. And now I have to use that to kind of decide what I actually ought to do. Now, if we were doing the normal kind of tree search like we talked about with game search, I would just use my evaluation function. But I don't have an evaluation function. So instead, I'm going to do simulation. And what that means is I'm going to follow some other policy. We typically have a name for that. We call it the rollout policy. And just for the sake of discussion here, let's just say it's a random policy. So I'm going to say I took this particular action, I ended up in this particular state, and then I'm just going to behave randomly for a while. And then I'm going to do the same thing here. Yeah, that looks random. I'm going to do that here, and then I'm going to do that here, and then I'm going to do that here, and then I'm going to do that here, and I'm going to do that here, and I'm going to get a whole bunch of spaghetti. Now, the spaghetti actually has nice little bits. I know, spaghetti is delicious. The spaghetti actually has all kinds of nice information associated with it. As I move through this path and through this trajectory by behaving randomly, say, from this particular state, I actually see a bunch of rewards along the way, right? And I can just take that out as far as I need to, given my horizon, say, my discount factor. So I do this for a long time, and I collect rewards along the way. That gives me an estimate of being in this state and taking this particular action. And since I might take the same action multiple times and get to these states, I now can do a sort of average over all of these possibilities, get lots and lots of sort of estimates of this, and then that gives me an estimate of a Q value for each of the actions that I might take. So all I'm really doing is building an evaluation function by doing, well, Monte Carlo simulation from there. So I'm in the state, I took a bunch of actions, that gives me a concrete set of next states. From there, I just behave randomly for a while, I use that to gather a bunch of estimates of rewards, I add them all up, I average them appropriately, and now that gives me an estimate of the Q function. But by the way, it does more than that. Now that I have an estimate of the Q function for this state, backed up from here, I can actually back up information all the way to the top.
Mm.
And that updates the estimate of this particular node, and this particular node.